You know, the American, you know, we're the people by the people for the people. Now it's we the institutions by the institutions for the institutions. People are secondary. It's all about corporations and institutions. And the Federal Reserve is the biggest institution in the world. You know, if you ask somebody what's the biggest corporation in the world, they'll say Google or Walmart or Exxon or something. But the biggest corporation in the world is the Federal Reserve System, right? And all the other corporations feed off the nipple of the Federal Reserve System.
Well, it's like the Monopoly game. The bank always wins. It has unlimited money. It's not the people playing on the board.
Exactly.
The bank owns the board, the box, the
right,
and the shelf it's sitting on.
So, but that's because you gave them the ability to make the money. You have to take that away from them.
We need to take the bank away from the private bankers.
Exactly. You have to take the creation of money away from the private bankers, and you'll solve 95% of your problems.
Well, let me look at America. 10% growth rates every year, like China's having right now. The U.S. had 10% growth rates until the Federal Reserve took over. And then if you look at that, it all starts really going downhill from there.
Well, they destroyed the American worker. What they've done, here's what's happened. The Federal Reserve has created this massive inflation in America, which means that the American worker has to keep making more money to keep up with the cost of living. The more money they make to keep up with the cost of living, the less competitive they become in the world economy. So now what happens is we have to pay our workers so much to keep up with the cost of living, say, well, screw the American worker, let's go overseas now and get the cheap labor.
But really, that's a war being waged against the middle class.
Of course,
the bankers print the money. This is a war being waged against the middle class. The bankers print the money. Everything they're doing is about destroying any private pools of wealth or independence.
Yeah, but what I'm trying to say is, because of the inflation that they've created, they've now allowed other countries to outcompete us. You see, because other countries don't have to pay as much money as we have to pay here to our workers to survive.
Yes.
So now we're not competitive anymore. So we've lost our manufacturing base. We've lost our competitive. In the old days, the American worker, you wanted to buy everything American. You wouldn't buy anything from Japan. This was cheap crap.
And what does that leave us? It leaves America this military force, and so the elite's giving us a deal. We'll continue to build up your military and give you homeland security jobs, shift your economy over to being the bulldog enforcer of the New World Order.
Exactly.
And by controlling the economy, they force everybody into that position.
That's exactly correct. And there's no more manufacturing here. We're a service economy. We do nothing. We provide nothing. We provide nothing to the rest of the world anymore. Well, first of all, Freedom to Fascism is a movie that everybody should see. Because we show the fraud of the income tax. We show how judges put people in jail for no reason. We show the corruption of the justice system. And we show how the Federal Reserve came into being and how it's controlling society. And how all the central banks of the world are working together through the Bank of International Settlements in Switzerland, which is the central bank for all the central banks. And how they all work together to create this one world government, one world order, which is what they're trying to do. So, Freedom of Fascism is a movie just to get you a good basic education about how the world is really working. And I really want everybody to see that movie. Critical. In terms of the CFR, in terms of compartmentalization, I mean, there are many good people, I believe, that are part of these organizations who don't even understand what the organization's really about. People like when I was in Germany doing cancer treatment, there was a gentleman there who was a visiting a friend of his who had cancer, and he was a member of the CFR, and we were talking, and I showed him the movie. He said, "Oh my God, I'm going to resign. I had no idea what the CFR was about." He had no idea. He was just a nice guy who thought he was in this prestigious organization.
Yeah, a lot of it's about getting good people and so you can watch them. Keep your friends close, your enemies close.
Well, no, it wasn't even that. A lot of people join the CFR because they think it's a prestigious organization. It'll help them in business, make good business contacts. They didn't have an understanding that the CFR is really about world domination. About, you know, how they and the Trilateral Commission and the Bilderbergers all work together, you know, the banks to control the people. They don't, a lot of them don't understand that. They don't see the big picture. Oh, it's CFO, it's a prestigious organization. I'll make this one, I'll make that one. I can do good business deals out of it. It's just business to them. The CFO wants to get the people in there that have influence and power, you know, and so they're part of that. So they're not opposing them, you know. It's like the whole country today is becoming the haves and have-nots. You're getting the very, very wealthy, the middle class is being destroyed, and you're getting the poor people.
Isn't this just a slick mafia that took over and uses fancy PR?
Well, you can call it mafia, you can call it whatever you want, but it's definitely a criminal organization. There's no question about it. But it's a criminal organization that has prestige, you know, that appears to have, what's the word I'm looking for?
Class,
style, you know, it's like, you know, respected. It's respected. People don't look at it as being a criminal organization. That's what a great job they've done. You know, people look at Alan Greenspan as being a hero. You know, they're my maestro. Money's a funny thing. You know, I was talking to Michael Eisner one day, and I said to Michael, you know, you may have $1 billion, Michael, but they're all dollars. You know, you know, if the dollar goes bad, how much money are you going to have? You know, and that's the thing. You know. You know, everything is denominated in dollars. Everybody thinks in terms of dollars. The dollar has no value. And that someday it's everything returns to me.
Well, really, the whole universe, financial universe we live in, is a matrix problem.
Yes, it is. And that's why it's going to come crashing at some point. And they're going to try and hold it up as long as they can. I mean, whenever they want to manipulate the markets, they can. They want to send the price to go down lower, they can. They want to send the stock market up, they can. They do that. There's no more free markets. You don't live in a society where free markets rule anymore. You don't live in a capitalistic society, you know.
But meanwhile, they say it's capitalistic right. And free market all day, when really they're waging war financially and politically.
Exactly right.
Aaron Russo, I want to thank you for this interview. Anything else you want to add?
No, I'm happy to do it for you.
How about your website?
My website, freedomsoffascism.com. Go over there, take a look at it, you know. But just, folks, you know, all I can say is, you know, take our country back. Restore the Constitution. Don't let these bankers do this to us anymore. Stand up. Don't be afraid of them. And do what you got to do. You know, and I have plans in the works. And when I get over my problems, you know, we'll reveal them. You know?
And, well, I'll be supportive of that.
Thank you, Hassan. Listen, you've done a great job alerting people to the truth. And don't be afraid to be ridiculed by these people. You know, if 9/11 was a phony, and I know it was, then stand up and say it's a phony. Don't be scared to tell the truth. Don't allow their their powers of trying to make you look silly to frighten you.
What did you think of what Charlie Sheen did?
I love what Charlie Sheen did. I was respectful of what he did. I just applauded him.
People saw right through that attack. They like flipped the light switch and whatever.
Yeah, but you see, they don't. You see, the thing is that more people don't come out and do it. You know, to build that wave, Charlie did it. I'm really proud of the guy.
David Lynch did it, but the media was smart and didn't bite this time.
Right. I mean, a few people have, but they're not picking up on it because they control the media.
James Brolin did it.
I heard that as well. But again, they're not picking
Barbara
up.
Barbara Walters, like she's having a heart attack.
But they don't pick up on it. You see, they don't allow it to go anywhere. You know, it comes. If someone says something, they let it die. You know, they keep perpetuating. You know, the war on terrorism. They keep perpetuating all these things that are lies. And because we've given the Federal Reserve the money-making power, they control the media. They control the government. And they're all in bed together. So you're fighting all this propaganda all the time. And it's a very difficult fight.